Apple just had its second event within the last month, and they announced a bunch of new stuff. So let's talk about it. They started off talking about Apple Music and Siri. Siri is now going to be more helpful, getting music playing for more situations. For example, you can ask for a dinner party playlist or a playlist to relax to. When something is playing, you can also have Siri play more music like the current song for a more personalized experience. Speaking of Apple Music and Siri, there's a new way for Apple to take your money. I mean, a new subscription tier. It's the Apple Music Voice Plan. For $4.99 per month, you get access to the Apple Music catalog, but you have to use Siri to do all the control. Also, according to Apple, you'll get a custom in-app experience with music suggestions, recently played, and tips on how to use Siri with Apple Music. This plan doesn't include spatial audio, lossless audio, lyrics, or music videos. Nothing too exciting here, but I can see this being nice for the right person. People who have a HomePod and just want to ask Siri for music, just to get something playing. I've even thought about something like this before for myself as a Spotify user. I have to AirPlay everything to my HomePods, and with this I could just get the ease of voice control. Next, Apple actually mentioned the HomePod Mini, which came as a bit of a surprise to me. There's new colors, orange, blue, and yellow, in addition to the white and black that we already had. They have a colored fabric and a tinted touch surface. These colors don't really do anything for me personally, but I guess I'm kind of boring. I mean, I have a black iPhone, a black Apple Watch, and black HomePods. But if it's something that you're into, that's awesome. Continuing on with music, there's also updated AirPods. Just the base AirPods, not Pros or the Max. The big new thing here is an updated design. They look just like the AirPods Pro, but without the rubber tips. They have a very similar looking shape to the Pros, a force sensor on the stalks for the controls, just like the Pros, sweat and water resistance, and a brand new audio driver. It's impossible to say how they'll sound without actually having them, but I'm not really sure that it matters. The AirPods are completely an experience-driven product. Everything about using them was way better than what we had before, so the sound quality never really mattered that much. Any improvements to sound quality are just an added bonus. Oh, and they added MagSafe charging to the case, which I think will be nice. I've recently gone all in on the MagSafe Life, and it's pretty nice so far, so I can see this being a nice addition here as well. They sell for $179, and I'm sure Apple will sell a ton of them. Okay, now we move on to the stars of the show, the new MacBook Pros. Apple has a new design, new screens, new keyboards, and new chips. In addition to last year's fantastic M1 chips, we now have the M1 Pro and the M1 Max. It's a little bit hard to comprehend how fast these are without using them. Apple dumped a ton of specs and comparisons on us, but to put it simply, they look incredible. You can go from an 8-core CPU with 14-core GPU to a 10-core CPU and a 32-core GPU. For memory, you can go from 16 gigs, which the M1 maxed out at, all the way up to 64 gigs, depending on the configuration. There's no question that these are going to be fast. It's just yet to be determined how fast. The M1 was already an extremely impressive chip, even without fans like in the Air. And the M1 Pro and Max are likely going to be way, way better. And it actually makes me wonder what's really even necessary at this point. I mean, yeah, you have to take into account, like, if you buy something now, how long will it last? But I really think if you're happy with the M1, there's probably really not that much of a reason for you to be considering a new thing unless you just want the best and greatest and latest thing. These laptops also feature a new design and a bunch of new ports. There's now HDMI, SD card, MagSafe, and Thunderbolt. Besides MagSafe, all of these seem like obvious additions that maybe shouldn't have ever been removed. I'm kind of torn on MagSafe though. I like the idea and I like to use a computer with MagSafe. I just think Thunderbolt, the port is so much more versatile. And if I'm going to take up the space, I'd rather have something that I can use for a number of different things. There's a brand new 14.2-inch and 16.2-inch Liquid Retina XDR display that have ProMotion, and you probably noticed there's a notch. And I mean, the notch, it looks kind of dumb at first, but I'm sure just like on the phone, it's just gonna fade away and you won't really notice it. Plus, I mean, it's pretty much always gonna be sitting up in the menu bar, and like I said, I just don't think you're gonna notice it after a day of using the computer. Besides the notch, the displays look like they're gonna be awesome. There's smaller bezels, much smaller than what we're used to. ProMotion is gonna look great just like on the phones and the iPads, and the screens get so much brighter. That's one gripe that I have about using my M1 Air is that I don't think the screen gets bright enough. So these 1000 nit screens are gonna be awesome on the Pros. The next thing you may have noticed is that there's no more touch bar. I never personally used a laptop with a touch bar, and I also really never wanted to. I think this feature was kind of divided among MacBook users. Some people really liked it and other people just didn't. So they took the touch bar out and added a full-size row of function keys. They also finally upgraded the webcam in the new MacBook Pros, going to 1080p, and they say it can take in way more light and it's gonna look much better than what we had before, which honestly isn't that hard to beat. So I'm glad that they finally did something here. Next, there's an all new 6-speaker system that's in both the 14-inch and 16-inch MacBook Pros that Apple says is gonna give you a lot more bass, and you'll also get spatial audio. I'm sure this is gonna sound great, as Apple's audio engineers have been killing it lately. So it'll be exciting to hear how great these new laptops sound. And finally, Apple talked about battery life, which according to Apple, you'll get about 17 hours of video playback on the 14-inch and 21 hours of video playback on the 16-inch. Again, battery life has been really great on the M1 laptops so far, so I can only imagine that it's gonna be even better on these. And it's pretty exciting how much use you can get on a single charge nowadays. The 14-inch is gonna start at $19.99 and the 16-inch is gonna start at $24.99, and you can get them in silver or space gray. I have to say, after this event was over, I was super excited about the new laptops and I was ready to trade in my Air and place an order. The performance on these looks like it's gonna be insane, and just the new design with these really nice looking new screens and smaller bezels, I think it's just gonna be a great improvement, not to mention not having to use dongles for things like SD cards or plugging into an external monitor over HDMI, and just having more ports in general. After thinking about it for a while now, I think I am gonna stick with my Air for now because it really does function really well still, and it does everything that I need it to. But I think if you've been holding out and you've been able to skip the M1, these new laptops are gonna be amazing and you can't go wrong with getting any configuration.